We have some breaking business news this morning. Fresh numbers from south of the border, the latest CPI, Consumer Price Index in the United States, where the inflation rate hovering around 3.5%. So, Peter Armstrong, our senior business correspondent, what are the numbers? What do they mean? Good morning, Peter.
Good morning, Heather. And look, I think we can get into the sort of details here of, you know, what this means for used car sales and refrigerators in a second, but just zoom out with me for a second, and I think you can start to see a bigger picture emerge. And it's that, look, and getting inflation all the way back down to target is going to take time. Just before we came on, I was trying to look up where we were this time last year in the U.S. We can get to the Canadian numbers in a second. But it was like 6.9, 6.8%. And now we're all the way down to 3.4% is the headline number, which is still really good. It's just a reacceleration from where we had been. And I think everybody gets it into their head that you're going to see these inflation numbers, once they start to move sort of inexorably in a straight line to that 2% target. And that's simply not the case. We saw a reacceleration of price growth through December. And you can sort of understand why, right? We're all out shopping. There's a lot of things happening. The economy has been more resilient than I think a lot of us had been expecting. The question, though, is where do we go from here? And I don't think this really moves the target all that much in terms of where do we think inflation is going to be in 4 months or 6 months or 8 months? And what do we think this really means for the Fed and for central banks around the world that are looking at these numbers, trying to figure out where they need to set their policy? This might delay the Fed by a little bit, but it's certainly not going to change course. I think we still need to understand inflation is definitely moving in the right target on a broad scheme, and we're going to have little wobbles along the way. And I think, you know, the easy part was getting from the peak at, it peaked here in Canada at 8.1%, even higher in the United States. Getting from there to around 3.5% was the easy part. Getting from 3.5% all the way down to that target of 2%, that's going to be the tough work. And I think the message I'm getting from these numbers today is that tough work is still coming at us.
So how does this intersect then, Peter, with the Canadian story? Any implications for the trend here?
Yeah, look, I think you can look at today's numbers as a really good template for what you and I are going to be talking about when the Canadian CPI numbers come out. I think that's next Tuesday. This is a really good indicator, right? With Canadian consumers, American consumers have largely been behaving, the consumers, I'm not talking about the broader economy, but largely behaving in similar ways. And so those price growth trends and the stubbornness of inflation is behaving in a very similar way in Canada as in the United States. So I think next week when we get the Canadian numbers, we're going to see something quite similar where we'll see a bit of a reacceleration, right? We were down to 3.1% and then it held at 3.1%. This month, I think we're expecting to see it around 3.2, 3.4%. So very similar to what we're seeing in the United States. But again, I think the broader trend that we're watching in the United States is going to apply here. That this isn't a long-term reacceleration. Call it a wobble. It's going back up a little bit, but we're still expected over the first and second quarter of this year, of 2024, to get that back to target, back within the target range. The Bank of Canada's range is between 1 and 3%. The midpoint of that 2% is the actual target. I think we're still very much expecting to stay on that, but we're going to have some wobbles along the way as price growth reaccelerates a little bit and then goes down a little bit. So, you know, it is something to watch as we get those numbers out of Canada next week.
Okay, I was writing all of it down, and you're going to come back next week, and we'll talk about it then, okay, again, ahead of the Bank of Canada's announcement. Thank you so much, Peter. Really appreciate it.